All right, so I'm gonna make a video today about how to take off the fender and the hood. I'm gonna start with by disconnecting both these batteries. At least in my case, each one of these battery terminals is an 8mm bolt. So I'm gonna go ahead and do those first. All right, both batteries are disconnected. I took this one out because you're gonna have to if you have a diesel. The next thing I'm gonna do is take out this air box. And it's just a flathead screw to loosen up that band clamp, and then I'm just going to pop the air box out and then tuck this up out of the way. After you get the band clamp disconnected and pushed out of the side, you're going to need to remove this, I think it's the MAF sensor. It's just a little clip right here, and it should push off. Most likely these are going to be a little bit stuck, so a flathead screwdriver is going to help. Alright, after I undid the MAF sensor, it pulled right out. In your case, you're going to have a air box plate right here, and the air box will most likely be mounted to that. Because this truck was in an accident, the little plastic bolts or rivets that went from the air box into the plate just broke, and I previously took out the plate. Now you have to take out the coolant reservoir. There's a 10mm bolt there, and a 10mm bolt there that connects to the battery tray. Alright, the next thing you're going to have to unbolt is this battery tray. There's four half-inch bolts right here, here, and then one and two. But before that, there is going to be three 10mm bolts here. I have one right here and one right here. Also, one goes in right here. I didn't put it in when I was mocking everything up just for the ease of it. There's one more 10mm bolt right here. I'm not sure if you're gonna have to take that out or not. I'll let you know. All right, so the battery tray's out. On this last fourth bolt right here, I'd recommend taking out the inner fender. It's a lot easier to get onto it, but you can just as easily get onto it from up above without taking out the inner fender first. And on the battery tray, it is also unnecessary to take out this bolt and the battery protector bolt, or the anti-vibration bolt. All right, so I just got the hood off, which is just three bolts on each side. You'll need an extra pair of hands for that. That's pretty, well, not really difficult, but it'll easily help with another pair of hands. Okay, so to get this fender off, there's two bolts right there I have taken out. There's one bolt right there I have taken out. And inside of the door, there's one right there you can see, and then we'll move down a little bit, and then there's another one there you can see. There is one bolt underneath the fender. The lighting's gonna be terrible. It's right here. And the fender will come right off.